गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडेज टॉपिक इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ इंटीजर्स. लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड हाउ टू ऐड एंड सब्ट्रैक्ट इंटीजर्स. नाउ वी विल सी हाउ टू मल्टीप्लाई इंटीजर्स. ओके, कंसिडर एनी टू इंटीजर्स. ओके, ए एंड बी. ओके, नाउ आई एम मल्टीप्लाइंग ए एंड बी. आई एम गेटिंग समथिंग अ सी. C is also integer. Take any two integers A and B and multiply it, and the answer is C. Now, what is this? A into B is C. Then what is A multiplied by minus B? A multiplied by minus B will be minus C, and minus A multiplied by B will be minus C, and minus A multiplied by minus B is C. Okay, what is this? Is if you multiply two integers such that positive positive, this is the product. It's minus minus plus minus minus. Okay, if you multiply any two positive, the result will be positive. Here it will be negative, negative, and here it will be positive. Okay, this thing you have to keep it in mind. So for example, the same thing you see, 5 multiplied by 4. Okay, what is 5 fours are 20. The same thing, 5 multiplied by minus 4 will be minus 20. So minus 5 multiplied by 4 is, that is also minus 20. Minus 5 multiplied by minus 4, that is 20. Okay, so plus into plus, plus, plus into minus, minus, minus into plus, minus, minus into minus, plus. These are the only four cases when you consider any two integers. If you see here, here is also a 20. And here is also a 20. Okay, so what is that? What does it says? So 5 multiplied by 4 is equal to minus 5 multiplied by minus 4. The answer is 20. Similarly, if you see, this is also minus 20 and this is also minus 20. So 5 multiplied by minus 4 equal to minus 5 multiplied by 4. That is equal to minus 20. These two are very important results that you have to apply in your problems. So first statement says, whether you multiply both to be positive and both to be negative, the result is going to be the same. Here one thing positive and one thing negative. So in general, we can say A multiplied by B is same as minus A multiplied by minus B. Similarly, A multiplied by minus B is going to be same as minus A multiplied by B. These two are the very important results regarding multiplication of integers. Let me take some examples. So here, if I take 3 multiplied by 2, okay, what is this? 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. And similarly, minus 3 multiplied by minus 3 is also 6. Okay. Another case is 3 multiplied by minus 2 is minus 6. Plus into minus, minus. So even I can write like minus 3 multiplied by 2 is also minus 6. Okay. So we can see whether the negative sign is here or here, they both have the same result. The two positive integers or two both negative integers, the result will be the same. So main important cases, you have to remember this four cases: plus into plus, plus, plus into minus, minus, minus into plus, minus, minus into minus, plus. These four cases you have to remember. Added to that, you have to remember this: A multiplied by B is same as minus A multiplied by minus B. Similarly, A multiplied by minus B is same as minus A multiplied by B. The next topic is product of three or more negative integers. Now, let me take some 3 negative integers. Minus 3 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by minus 2. Okay, now 4, 3 fours are 12, this together gives 12, then 12 multiplied by 2 is 24. Okay, now this minus in minus 3 multiplied by minus 4 is minus, minus into minus is plus, this is 12. And again this 12 multiplied by 12 multiplied by minus 2 will be minus 24. So, the answer here is minus 24. Now, the same case if I am doing minus 3 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by 2, the 24 will remain the same, but what happened to the sign? This minus into minus becomes plus. Okay, then plus into plus becomes, here it will be plus. What we can say is, in finding a product, we have to count the number of negative integers. If the number of negative integers is even, then the product is a positive integer. If the number of negative integers is odd, then the product is a negative integer. Okay, we will see some examples. Same example you can take, minus 3 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by minus 2. The answer is 3 4s are 12, 12 2s are 24. Here you have to count how many negative integers are there. The number of negative integers is 3, 1, 2 and 3. Totally there are 3 negative integers. If the number of negative integers is even, then the product is a positive, but here the number of negative integers is odd, so the product is a negative integer. We can take one more example, minus 3 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by 2. Here the number of negative integers is 2, so the product is a positive integer. We can try with minus 1 multiplied by minus 1. What is minus 1 multiplied by minus 1? Here the number of negative integer is 2, even. This is a even case. So, if it is even, the product is positive. 1 multiplied by 1 is 1. If I am going on increasing, minus 1 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 1. If you see here, the number of negative integer is 3. So, that is odd. If it is odd, the answer is negative integer minus 1. Again, minus 1 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 1. Here the number of negative integer is 4, that is even. Then the product is a positive integer 1. Again, minus 1 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by minus 1, that is equal to minus 1. Here there are 5 negative integers. So, if the number of negative integers is even, the product is positive. If the number of negative integers is odd, the product is negative. So, if you multiply minus 1 for odd number of times, the result is going to be minus 1. If you multiply minus 1 for even number of times, the result is 1. Here the result is negative and here the result is positive. Now, what will be the sign of the product if we multiply together? First question is 8 negative integers and 3 positive integers. So, they didn't mention what are the numbers. They just told there are 8 negative integers and 3 positive integers. Totally there are 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 integers are there. Some number. Okay, like that. Some number are there. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are all negative integers multiplied by 3 positive integers. Multiplied by, okay, totally there are 11. Out of them 8 are negative and 3 are positive. They are asking what is the sign of the product. Okay, they didn't give what are the numbers are. They just mentioned there are 8 negative integers. Okay, so you have to see whether number of negative integers are odd or even. If the here it is 8, 8 is even. If the number of negative integers is even, the result is a positive. So here, so when you multiply all these 8 negative integers, we will get the result as a positive integer. So here the positive integer multiplied by these 3 positive integers, the result is positive. The next is 5 negative integers and 4 positive integers. So here you are going to see 5, 3, 4, 5, some negative integers and 4 positive integers. Okay, so here 5 is a odd number. Okay, so multiplication of these 5 negative integers will give a negative integer. So this negative integer multiplied this, here it is positive. Positive minus into plus gives the answer is in negative integer. Here you see, here there are 3 positive integers and here there are 4 positive integers. While multiplying positive integer, you need not to worry whether it is even or odd. Whatever it is, either even or odd, when you multiply positive integer, result is going to be a positive integer only. So only you have to consider the negative integers. Okay, here you see the 8, it is a even, so the result is positive. Here the 5, which is an odd number, so the result is negative. Now, if you are multiplying minus 1 for 12 times, I am multiplying minus 1 for 12 times, 12 is an even number, so the result is going to be a positive. So it is plus 1. Suppose instead of 12, 13 is given, which is an odd, the result is minus 1. So next problem is, here you are multiplying minus 1 for 2m times, where m is a natural number. What is a natural number? M is 1, 2, 3, 4 and it will go on like this. Okay, so you are multiplying minus 1 for 2m times, which means if m is 1, which is just minus 1. Okay, sorry, if m is 1, what is 2m is? Here m, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. Now what is 2m? That is 2m is 2 multiplied by m. You have to multiply this m by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 4, 6, 8. So it will go on like this. What does it mean? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 2m is, which means even number. Okay, so minus 1 is multiplied 2m times. M is a natural number. If m is a natural number, it will goes like 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the 2m then? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, where 2m is an even number. So what will happen when minus 1 is multiplied for even number of times? So minus 1, 2m times, then it is a positive integer because 2m is an even number. So minus 1 multiplied for even number of times will give a positive integer. Now we are going to see about properties of multiplication of integers. The first property is closure under multiplication. Similar closure property we studied in addition and subtraction also. Now what is closure property means? So I am taking any two integers a and b. Okay, I am multiplying, I am getting c. If a is an integer, b is an integer, after multiplying, if c is also an integer, then you can say integers are closed under multiplication. For example, let me take 4. Okay, 4 is an integer. And minus 3. Minus 3 is also an integer. The answer is minus 12. Minus 12 also an integer. So we can say integers are closed under multiplication. Some example, minus 6 integer multiplied by minus 2. What is that? This minus into minus becomes plus. 6 2s are 12. So 12 is also integer. So integers are closed under multiplication. Okay. The next property is commutative property. What is commutative property is, if A multiplied by B is equal to B multiplied by A, you have to check this whether this holds. Then you can say multiplication is commutative for integers. So what is that? 3 multiplied by 2 is same as 2 multiplied by 3. 3 2s are 6 and 2 3s are 6. Similarly, 4 multiplied by minus 3. That is equal to, what is 4 multiplied by minus 3? You know that is minus 12. Is that the same as minus 3 multiplied by 4? It's the same. 4 3 is 12 minus. So we can say A multiplied by B equal to B multiplied by A. So we can say multiplication is commutative for integers. Then you know multiplication by 0. If you multiply any integer by 0, 5 multiplied by 0, what's the answer? 0. Minus 3 multiplied by 0, answer is 0. So, if A is an integer, A multiplied by 0 or 0 multiplied by A, that is equal to 0. Okay? This is one of the property. Next is multiplicative identity. So, for integers, 1 is the multiplicative identity. If you multiply any integer with 1, the result is the same integer. So 3 multiplied by 1 is 3. Minus 3 multiplied by 1 is minus 3. Okay, 0 multiplied by 1 is 0. 5 multiplied by 1 is 5. So 1 is the multiplicative identity for integers. What is multiplicative identity is? If you multiply 1 with any number, any integer, you should get the same integer. Now the question is minus 1 is multiplicative identity? Multiplicative identity. Can we say minus 1 as the multiplicative identity? Let me check that. So what happens if I multiplied by 3 with minus 1? Will I get the same 3 here? No, what I will get is minus 3. Okay, suppose if I multiplied minus 4 with minus 1, what I will get? The answer is 4. So here it is 3 and here it is minus 3, which both are different. They are not the same integers. So the answer is no. Minus 1 is not the multiplicative identity. 1 is the multiplicative identity. Next is associative property we are going to see for multiplication. This is very simple. Take any three integers. Whether you multiplied in this order is the same as if you interchange the order. Okay. So here I am taking A as 3, B is minus 2 and C is minus 5. First thing I am multiplying A multiplied by B and C. So here A is 3 and B is minus 2 and C is minus 5. First I am multiplying, what is 3 multiplied by minus 2 is minus 6 multiplied by minus 5. Here minus into minus become plus, 6 5s are 30. Now we can see here I am first multiplying A and B, to that I am multiplying C. So I am getting 30 here. In the second case, I am first doing B multiplied by C. So what is here? Minus into minus becomes plus, 5 2s are 10. So 3 multiplied by 10 is 30. So here what I am saying is, in associative properties says, in multiplication of integers, even you change the order of multiplication, the result is going to be the same. The last one is distributive property, which says A multiplied by B plus C. Okay, A multiplied by B plus C is same as A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. Okay, which means a multiplied by b plus c. First you have to multiply a with b, which gives a multiplied by b. Then here is a plus, plus, then again you have to multiply a with c, a multiplied by c. This is called distributive property. The same thing we can write for b minus c, which means a multiplied by b, okay, that's minus, because here's a minus, then a multiplied by c. Okay, so a multiplied by b minus c equal to a multiplied by b minus a multiplied by c. These two cases are distributive property. Okay, now let me do some examples to find this. So 2 multiplied by 3 plus 5. Okay, 2 multiplied by 3 plus 5 is equal to 2 multiplied by 3 plus 2 multiplied by 5. 2 multiplied by 3 plus 2 multiplied by 5. Here a equal to 2, b equal to 3, and c equal to 5. Okay, so which is a multiplied by b plus c, that is equal to a multiplied by b plus a multiplied by c. Now let me check the left hand side, which is 2 multiplied by 3 plus 5, which is 2 multiplied by, what is 5 plus 3 is 8, that is 16. The left hand side answer is 16. Now move to the right hand side, which is 2 multiplied by 3 plus 2 multiplied by 5, that is equal to, what is 3, 2, 2 3s are 6, plus 2 5s are 10, that is equal to 16. Therefore, the left hand side equal to right hand side, which means either you do a multiplied by b plus c, which is same as a multiplied by b plus a multiplied by c. Okay, we'll start with example 2. Find each of the following products. Okay, so that is equal to, now here minus into minus becomes plus. What is 18 multiplied by 100 is 180 multiplied by 9. Here minus into minus becomes plus. So 180 multiplied by 9 is 1620. Okay, the next is minus 20 multiplied by minus 2 multiplied by minus 5 multiplied by 7. Here the number of negative integer is, what is the number of negative integers is odd, so the result should be a negative integer. So let me check it. So first I am taking minus 20 here. I am multiplying, what is 5 multiplied by 2? 5 2s are 10. This minus into minus plus multiplied by 7. Okay, now what is this minus 20? Either you can do 7 into 10 or minus 20. Okay, let me do. What is 7 tens are 70. Okay, now this plus into minus minus, 7 twos are 14, 0, 0. You can see here the product is negative, which means if the number of negative integer is odd, 1, 2, 3, there are 3 negative integers, so the product is also negative. Okay, now the next problem is here, so minus 1 multiplied by minus 5. Okay, this I will do it first, then minus 4 multiplied by minus 6. What is this minus into minus becomes minus into minus plus. 5 ones are 5 multiplied by this minus into minus plus, 6 fours are 24, that is equal to 120. Here you can see the number of negative integer is even, 4, which is an even number, so the result is a positive number. Now example 3, verify. So now we have to verify whether the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Okay, let me take the left hand side. What is given is minus 30 multiplied by 13 plus of minus 3. Okay, so first you have to do which is inside the bracket. Minus 30 multiplied by what is inside the bracket is 13 plus or minus 3. Okay, so 13 plus of minus 3. This is plus of minus. This is 13 minus 3. Because we did so many times, a plus of minus b, which is same as a minus b. Okay, so here 13 plus of minus 3 is 13 minus 3. That is equal to 10. So instead of this 13 plus of minus 3, I am going to substitute 10. Okay, now what is 30 multiplied by 100 is 300. So plus into minus minus. This is for the left hand side. Let me try for right hand side. What is given? Minus 30 multiplied by 13 plus minus 30 multiplied by minus 3. Okay, first I have to multiply 30 multiplied by 13. 30 multiplied by 13 is 390 with a minus sign. So plus into minus minus. This is 1 plus. What is this? Minus into minus plus. 3 3s are 9. This is 90. So what is minus 390 plus 90? Okay, which is equal to here you can say one is positive, another one is negative. So you have to subtract and give the greater number sign. So 390 minus 90 is 300 minus 300. So you can say left hand side equal to right hand side, therefore verified. Okay, the next problem is, in a class test containing 15 questions, 4 marks are given for every correct answers and minus 2 marks are given for every incorrect answers. Gurpreet attempts all questions but only 9 of her answers are correct. What is her total score? First you will solve this problem. So in a class test, the total number of question is 15. For every correct answer, there is 4 mark for each correct answer and minus 2. What is minus 2 is the mark is reduced. Okay, for every incorrect answer, they are reducing the mark. So it is given as negative. So minus 2 marks for given every incorrect answer. Gurpreet attempts all questions, but only 9 of her answers are correct. So first we will start first problem. Number of correct answers. Okay, how many answers she attempted correctly? She attempted 9 correctly. Okay, now marks for 9 correct answer. Okay, so for 1 correct answer, the mark is 4. For 1 correct answer, the mark is 4 marks for given for every correct answer. So here it is 9. So 9 multiplied by 4, that is equal to 36. Okay, this is for the correct answers. For total of 9 correct answers, she scored 36. Now let me see about number of incorrect answers. Okay, number of totally there are 15 questions. The total question is 15. Out of that, 9 is correct. So 15 minus 9 is, so remaining 15 minus 9 is 6. Number of incorrect answer is 6. For every incorrect answer, minus 2, that is 2 mark is reduced. So marks for 6 incorrect answer. Marks for 6 incorrect answer is, totally there are 6 incorrect answer multiplied by minus 2. For every incorrect answer, 2 mark is reduced. So 6 multiplied by minus 2 is minus 12. Okay. Total score. total score is. So for correct answers she scored 36, for incorrect answer it is minus 12. Okay, which is 36 minus 12, that is equal to 24. So the total score is 24. So first you have to find number of correct answers and number of incorrect answers. So you have to multiply it by the how many correct answers she attempted. 9 correct answers with the marks is 4 for each correct answer. Then you have to multiply. Similarly, you have to do for incorrect answer. Then you have to add up together to get the total score. Okay. One more problem is there. One of her friends gets only 5 answers correct. So there are only 5 answers correct. Now how to solve this? Only 5 answers are correct. Marks for 5 correct answer. Marks for 5 correct answer is 4 multiplied by 5 is 20. Okay. So number of incorrect answer is, totally there are 15 questions. Out of that, 5 is correct. So incorrect is 15 minus 5, 10. So marks for how many 10 incorrect answers? Marks for 10 incorrect answer is 10 multiplied by minus 2, that is equal to minus 20. Okay, so what is the total score? For the correct answers, she scored 20 marks. Okay, for the wrong answers, incorrect answers, there is a negative 20 marks. So which means 20 minus 20, the answer is 0. The total score is 0. Next problem is, suppose we represent the distance above the ground by a positive integer and that below the ground by a negative integer, then answer the following. An elevator descends into mine shaft at the rate of 5 meter per minute. What will be its position after 1 hour? So now this is the ground level. Okay, so elevator starts from here, it travels to a distance of 5 meter, it taking some 1 minute, that is for 1 minute it travels for 5 meters. So from here to here, you can say the elevator took 1 minute to travel 5 meters. So if we take another 1 minute, it can travel for another 5 meters. So totally after, suppose we take after 2 minutes, it travels 10 meter below the ground level. Okay. Now the question is, what will be its position after 1 hour? So 1 hour is 60 minutes. Position after 1 hour. Okay, that is after 60 minutes. Either way you can write. After 60 minutes. For every 1 minute, it travels 5 meters. For every 1 minute, it travels 5 meters. So how much it will travel in 60 meters? So 5 multiplied by 60, that is equal to 300 meters. So 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute. If you go on for 60 minutes, it will reach 300 meters below the ground level. Main thing is here, it is 300 meters below the ground level. In question, they have given us below the ground level is denoted by a negative integer. So it should be minus 300 meter. Here we can denote by a negative sign because this 5 meter is below the ground level. So here it is a minus sign here. So minus 5 multiplied by 60 is minus 300. So either you can say 300 meter below the ground level or it is minus 300 meter. Okay. Now the next question is, if it begins to descend from 15 meter above the ground, what will be its position after 45 minutes? Suppose the elevator is here. Previous case, elevator is here. Now the elevator is in this position. They are asking what will be its position after 45 minutes. Now let me check if the elevator starts from here. If the elevator starts from here, what is its position after 45 minutes? position after 45 minutes. Okay, from the ground level. From I'm calculating from here, what is its position after 45 minutes? So it is moving down for 5 meters per minute. So minus 5 multiplied by 45. Okay, so minus 5 multiplied by 45 is minus 225 meter. So suppose this is 15 meter. It is 225 is somewhere from here. Somewhere from here. Okay. This is the position. If the elevator starts from here, after 45 minutes, its position will be 225 meter below the ground level. But now elevator starts from 15 meter above the ground level. It didn't start from here. It started from 15 meter above the ground level. So here you have to subtract the 15 meter from this distance. So what I should do is, therefore, final position of the elevator, that is equal to minus 225 plus 15, that is equal to minus 210 meter. Okay, so now we have to calculate what is this distance. This is some 15. Okay, out of this total distance you are moving this to here. Okay, so the answer is minus 210 meter, that is 210 meter below the ground level. Next class we will start exercise 1.3. Thank you.